First of all, I'm gonna start the recording. We will record this and we will put this on to our website, as well as you have access to the slide deck and the necessary resources to help you successfully sell backup and disaster recovery. Since we only have 30 minutes and actually cut that down by five, I will read all the questions at the end and answer as many as we have time for. Quick introduction, who I am and who HEROware is. My name is Fred Main. I'm the Executive Vice President of Worldwide Sales and Marketing for HEROware and one of the co-founders of HEROware. And as a business owner, I certainly understand how important it is to be successful selling and marketing your goods and services, regardless of where you are and what you're doing and what market you happen to be playing in. My background, 30 plus years in technology sales and marketing with resellers, Business Land, Intercom, CompuCom, and Icon. So I think from that perspective, I have a pretty good sense of what people need in the channel. I also was in distribution for a couple of years with Maricel. For those of you that are a little bit gray around the temple like I am, Maricel was at one time part of the big three, Ingram, Tech, and Maricel. And I ran the Western region, which was about a $500 million territory. I had 75 indirect reports and 12 direct reports. That was a tough job, obviously, competing with Ingram and Tech every day. We made the most of it. Unfortunately, they didn't survive the battle. But it was a great learning experience, part of my educational course, as I like to say. I had an MBA in technology with never going to college for the MBA component. Of course, I also needed to do manufacturing, so I spent about 5 years at Dell in the late 80s. And for you tech geeks out there, I was at NetFrame a few years, and that really gave me some insight into high-end technology. NetFrame was the precursor, really, to Compaq and their system, their server line. We competed against Tandem and some of the other major server manufacturers at the time. So that was really exciting for me. And I also spent 5 years recently at Cisco, and I was involved in the healthcare and Indian gaming vertical at Cisco, and with about a $10 million a year quota. So for roughly 5 years, I did about $70 million in sales for Cisco. So I think, that gave me a pretty good understanding of what's needed in the marketplace today. And really, Cisco was a great educational place from selling. So what I've done is I've incorporated pretty much all of these different industries and verticals and segments that I've worked in trying to make HEROware easy to sell and backup disaster recovery easy to sell. So it really did give me the ability as a business owner to have a true perspective of what everybody does every day on this call, and hopefully I can help you become more successful. If you do need us to help you sell during any time that you're out there pitching a product, hopefully the HEROware product line, don't hesitate to call on me, Fred Main, and anybody in my sales, marketing, and or a technology organization. At the end of the day, one of the things I loved about Cisco was everybody, including John Chambers, the CEO and chairman of the board, was responsible for selling. So that's the way we view ourselves here at Cisco. HEROware. If you have a best practice on how to sell, we would love to hear it. And if you have anything that we can post on our website, please send it our way, testimonial, video, whatever you have that would help describe the solution set that you have sold. We'd love to share that with everyone. So with no further ado, I will get in to the slideshow. Only three slides, and really four with my resource slides. So what do you need from backup and data protection? Before I start, quickly, the three slides that I have, I would either print them out and bring them with you to a customer, or have them on an iPad or some other device, a laptop, so you can show them to people. It's really a show and tell. Is how much you can show to folks, is how much you can be able to get the point across. And I think that's really critical when you're out presenting products to folks. They really, really want to be able to embrace the technology that you're providing to them. The number one slide here is you must get the data points on why the customer needs backup and disaster recovery solution. So they have to agree that they need protection from a disaster and their data is valuable. So as you see, and I go through these are traditional points that I just took out off the internet. And quite frankly, if you type in disaster recovery points, data points, and different things in the market, you will get a million of them. But I just picked these because these are very, you know, close to us in the SMB marketplace. And as you can see, most of these are from Gartner and IDC, you know, very large organizations that do have an effect on the industry because they are the ones that do all the research and provide all the data points. And we, as an organization, HEROware, we really look at these organizations as symbolic organizations, that they really do put out the right type of information that we can glean and understand and be able to put together the proper presentation so companies like you can go out there in the market and be able to present a proper business case to your customer. So with that in mind, you have to ask the customer, do these matter? Do points like this matter? And if they say no, none of this matters to me as an organization, that's pretty obvious. You need to move on. You know, if they don't think their business is valuable, if they don't think their data is important, if the cost of downtime to them is not important at $10,000 per hour that Gartner says, the survival rate for companies without a disaster recovery plan is less than 10%. That means that, you know, 1 out of 10 is going to stay in business. If that's not important to them and they don't agree with these type of numbers, then quite frankly, what you need to do is probably just get out of that company because they don't really have the value proposition around what their data is. Now, depending upon what they do for business, it's really going to help you understand how important that is to them. If they say yes, then obviously we're going to jump on to slide number two. And also a point to this is either the company doesn't care about the data, or quite frankly, you as a MSP or VAR or us HEROware, as an organization, we haven't done a good job of selling, and I hate to say, sometimes selling on the fear, the cost of the data loss, liabilities of the data loss internally and externally, and downtime. Those are the key critical components, and really, it's just one slide printed out or put it on a device so you could show it to them. And yeah, we've made a little bit of fun out of it here with this little guy up here, but it truly is. Do they really have a true disaster recovery plan that is more than help? I mean, do they have something written, and do they understand how to implement it? And if they lose their data, they may go out of business. That's to me is the most important piece as a business owner. If someone walked in my door and says, hey, you could potentially go out of business if you lost data, well, we're in a backup disaster recovery role. We understand the impact of that. So we put a lot of precautions in to make sure we don't lose our data and our customers' data, obviously. But you as a MSP and VAR need to make sure you educate them properly on exactly how important that is. So with that, we'll go to slide number two. And so this is really the interest slide. This is the slide that says, hey, okay, I'm very, very interested in what you have to say, Mr. Reseller, Fred, walking in the door. You've done a good job. You've got me excited. Now tell me about the different technologies that are out there and prove to me that you're educated on those technologies. So I can have this comfort level that I'm going to buy this type of technology from you. Well, at HEROware, we prescribe to you many different solution sets that are in the marketplace today. But one that we think is probably, from our perspective, the most compelling is it's called SHARE. At the bottom here, it's a volunteer-run group that was established in 1955 by an IBM mainframe user group. And quite frankly, they're still in business today. They have a Wikipedia that I've posted right there. And by the way, have copies of all these slides, as I said. And they have what they effectively called then the 7 tiers of disaster recovery. Today it's turned into 8 tiers because obviously a lot's happened since 1955. But I think this is a good background that you can run through with your customers and say, look, what do you want to ultimately accomplish? How much redundancy do you need as a company? And how can we do it as an organization together, to make sure we understand what the most effective solution for you. There are a lot of different solutions out there as I run through this, and you really need to stress, you know, you're a business consultant. You sit down and you look at a lot of different technologies in our marketplace today, and you're trying to find the highest level of data protection available at the right price point for the customer. So if you can show that to them, then they feel that there's a comfort level out there that you understand exactly what you're talking about. So I'm going to run through these fairly quickly. The tier one is data backup with no hot site. Now, really, the answer to this is tape. If you really read through the information in the shares information, this is tape. But I'm just going to say for the moment that everybody gets a check mark on this because that means that everybody has the ability to do some sort of backup. And if it's tape or if it's over the wire on the internet, if it's on site on an appliance or whatever it happens to be. Everybody gets a check mark, and they all get the benefit of the doubt on Tier 1, because that's a baseline level point. Number two is local data backup with a hot site. Okay, that means that they have cloud retrieval, and they have at least the ability to send the data back to the customer next business day on an encrypted USB drive. So does a local backup have that only? No. Does an offsite only have that? Possibly. I mean, that could be give or take in that scenario. Depends upon who you partner with. I'm giving the benefit of the doubt to the snapshot guys that are out there, because most of those guys that we compete with daily are our Axients and Datos and so on and so forth. You know, they have a ability to give you back your data next business day if you have a true disaster. And obviously so do we in HEROware. The third thing is electronic vaulting. This is the ability to do up to seven-year archiving, and maybe even longer than that. Some of the rules and regulations out there today require up to 21 years. Can they do it securely and privately? Can they withstand an audit? And as I said, I went through these, and really what we find is local backup only. No, you're not going to do that if you just have local backup. And a lot of that's referring to tape or just to this backup that's on-site. Off-site only cloud, yeah, this is what they do, right? They certainly have the ability to do that. And again, snapshot appliance providers and HEROware, real-time byte-level replication, which we do differently, and I'll get into that in a moment, certainly we got a check mark there. And these are what you can run through your customers if you understand the technology set and exactly how important these different technologies are to the customer. Number four, the fourth tier, point-in-time copies. This is the ability to rapidly recover entire servers and desktops in minutes with point-in-time technology. Fairly new, as we know. This has been out probably for 6 to 7 or 8 years, primarily using Microsoft's VSS technology. And I actually said, you know what, everybody gets a check mark in this one. Everybody's doing some sort of point-in-time recovery for the customer. I think it's a fair assumption that everybody gets a check mark here. Depends upon who you pick. And exactly what you would align yourself with. But for the most part, I think everybody does a decent job in this world. I think the snapshot guys do a real good job, and obviously HEROware does a real good job in this area too. The other guys, again, depends upon what level of solution you're using from the first two on this slide. You know, the decision is really based upon how much they're driving from a point-in-time component. Transaction integrity, no data loss. This is where the rubber starts meeting the road. This is where the differentials really start coming in to the different solution sets out there. Really what this means is real-time up-to-the-second server replication, that you're copying everything on that server set, regardless of how many servers there are, over to that backup device in real time. And how many of these guys can do it? Well, you can't do it to the cloud for sure. You're not doing it locally because tape and disk-to-disk aren't real-time. Those are set up in sequential, you know, hourly, daily, weekly type mode. Real time is real expensive, except for HEROware. So if I wanted to go real time today, I would go way up market. If HEROware was not in the market today, you'd be looking at EMC, NetApp, Hitachi. You know, we have this great partnership with DoubleTake, as some of you, if not all of you, know. And because of that, we hit the tier number five here, the transaction integrity component, you know, home run for us. No data loss. We have no data loss because everything's replicated to our appliance in real time at the byte level. So if it's on the production server or servers, it's on our appliance. Number six, and again, I'm not making these tiers up. This is part of the share. The IBM mainframe user group developed in 1955. Tier six was zero or near zero data loss. Again, the ability to have full server failover on limited Windows servers in minutes. And limited to no downtime is exactly what Tier 6 says. I could argue that nobody other than us does that. Now, you may argue that maybe some of the snapshot providers do that, so maybe you give them a half a point or a full check mark. That's totally up to you. But if we do a full server failover in 3 minutes, I would say that's zero or near zero. Probably downtime instead of data loss is really what I'm shooting for here. I've changed mine a little bit just because I already nailed the Tier 5 integrity. I look at downtime as another piece of the puzzle that needed to be really incorporated in this. And so we said limited to no downtime. 95% of our customers are getting no downtime with HEROware. If you do have downtime, it's just what it takes for you to reboot the VHD on our appliance. So that's really a tier six from our perspective, a check mark. On HEROware, again, argument may be a little bit snapshots. Give them a half a check if you want to do that. 7, well, recovery of applications is automated. This is critical. You really need to have the ability to recover all of your applications from an automated sequence. That means you're not picking a recovery point. We do what's called failover. You're getting failover instantly of all of those servers onto the HEROware appliance. You're not recovering to a location. You're not pointing to something and say, recover this snap to that and then spin that up. No, that's not the way we work. Ours is a VHD. It's pre-created. It's all ready to go. You just pick and choose which VHD you want to spin up, push a button, and it spins up in minutes. That's the beauty behind the HEROware appliance. You don't have to go through these extra steps of setting things up and mounting and recover points and all that. No, it's all pre-built, pre-set up, and ready for the disaster to happen, because we all know there will be a disaster eventually. And 8, the multi-dimensional location. They didn't really have a good name for this back in 1955. They used words like universe and multi-world tenancy, things like that. Basically what it means is redundant data centers. I was just on a call with our executive team, and we're going to have a redundant data center no later than June of this year. Matter of fact, we may even have it sooner than that. So that's going to give the multi-dimensional locations, that's exactly what they called in the share group in 1955 for the tiers of disaster recovery under tier number 8. The data would be protected from the destruction of a single location. So again, local backup only is not going to get that. So I gave check marks to the other two folks, because I'm thinking that most of the people I'm competing with day in and day out that you're probably talking to, or excuse me, that you may use day in and day out may actually have that. We're going to have that in June. So effectively, from a tiers of disaster recovery perspective, local backup only gives you 25%. And, you know, I could even argue that maybe that's pretty, I've been pretty generous on that. Offsite only cloud, again, we can argue is 50%. Real, well, I'd say it's, you know, maybe 50, 71, or maybe even a little bit lower. It could be only 3 out of 8 there. Snapshot appliance local and cloud, I put down 71%. Again, if we want to give them a full check or a half check on the tier number 5, that's fine. That just, you know, elevates them to 6 out of 8. So, again, there's nobody else in the SMB market today at the competitive price point that HEROware is at. They can offer 100% of IBM's tiers of disaster recovery. So we're very excited about that. Obviously, we are doing a lot of other things that don't show up in this chart, because, again, this is not everything that we talk about every single day, but this is a really good thing to put in front of your customers. And I can even brand this for you if you want. If you want this to be branded for your company, everything we can do, we can also brand, as I'm saying here, for our partners. So if they're nodding and say, hey, it's great, they love slide number 1, they buy into the technology. Slide number 2, they're starting to talk, okay, now what do you recommend, Mr. Partner Fred, for technology? And you go through this, you said, well, unless the price is not equal and unless something's totally out of whack here, why wouldn't I choose HEROware? And the answer is, great question. Now let's talk about the cost associated with it, because once you get buy-in and you get people to nod, I need the technology, I'm ready for it, let's talk about the cost of the solution. So can you afford a disaster recovery solution? After everything else we've talked about, all the costs associated with if you don't have it, and now what technology is available, you go through, okay, now, Mr. Customer, I understand your business. Every company strives for 3 things, and they may have more than that, but at a minimum, they need to increase revenues, right? You do that day in and day out. And HEROware increases our partners' revenues. We increase your revenue, and when you're pitching this customer, you can obviously take this component out, or we can rename it. You can say something like, hey, you know, if you're not down, maybe your revenues go up, whatever you want. But from my perspective, selling to you, my partner, I'm going to say that I'm going to increase your revenues, because you're going to sell a quality solution that is going to do what we say it's going to do. It's going to recover quick, fast. It's going to reduce your technology cycle, as far as how many people have to go on site to do the installations and failbacks. You can do everything remote. All the things that we do in a single pane of glass with our RMM solution. So we're going to increase your revenues day in and day out by using our solution. Reduce cost. Every company talks about that. We reduce your cost, Mr. Customer, Mr. Barr, but we also reduce the customer's cost by lowering their total cost of ownership. I'll get into that in a moment here. if they spend less money with a solution that just always works. Just always works, and not have to worry about finding the data, looking for the data, where's the data located? It's always available, always on, as I've said before, from a technology perspective, and we hit all eight of those tiers, then we effectively reduce their cost. And the last thing is increase customer satisfaction. We do both. Ideally, hopefully, I've increased your customer satisfaction from a partner of ours, and the customer's happier because they're always up. They're always working. They're not worried about their systems. From an approach standpoint, we, if they do have a disaster, we have them covered both locally and remote into a cloud. So we do hit those three things that customers strive and companies strive for every day. And as a valued partner of your customer, I would really walk them through these three components right here, because they need to know that you understand how important it is to talk about the three things that drive customers and their businesses every single day. Now, this is the sort of the creme de the creme. This slide right here, by the way, all of this is available on our website when we're done. We'll have it posted probably the end part of today. This slide right here, I know there's a lot on it, but it's really pretty easy to use. As I mentioned before, when I was at Cisco, one thing Cisco's really, really good on is selling. And we did a cost analysis on nearly every transaction to validate the return on investment or the total cost of ownership. And obviously, you can do either or both. This really is a good total cost of ownership analysis of using HEROware's full server failover versus traditional server restoration, which really was the slide before this that went through the different data points on that. The eight tiers from IBM. And the beauty of this really, it talks about, it really gets into the hard cost as opposed to soft cost. And I know people do not like to be sold based upon soft cost. Things like, you know, what if you use less paper, if you use this, you know, things like that. They want to know, what's my cost if I'm down? What's the burden? What is Gartner saying? What are these things that happen? Can I really get to my business? Do I operationally, am I potentially knocked out? And those are the things you look at. So as far as how this slide works, oops, apologize. Let me just double click on this for a second. I'm in trouble getting to that. Give me 1 second here. Okay. So this slide, I guess you can't use it in Excel inside of a presentation. So I'll get it out of a second. So I will give this to you. So this is just an Excel embedded slide into my presentation here. These two areas of yellow are the only two things you do. So the first one is how many servers you currently have, Microsoft Windows-based servers that you need protected. So in this case, I'm going to say I have two. Customer's environment, I'm using the industry numbers from Gartner, as you can see there. And this number 8 right here is a really interesting piece, the rating section. It lets the customer validate what their feelings are about themselves as an organization. This will help you understand how quickly you can close this opportunity by, based upon what they say they are from an organizational standpoint. The lower number, the better, but don't influence this. Don't sit there and try to get them to go to a lower number. Let them put whatever number in there that they want. You can certainly sit down and talk through them that, hey, you know, I got a customer yesterday, and they put in 2 here, and let me tell you a little bit about the company. They had really good network. It was fairly new. It was either Cisco, Juniper, whatever it was. And, you know, the technology, they're a couple years old on the desktop, and servers were only a couple years old, and they didn't have an IT staff, but, you know, we helped them support that. So from our perspective, they had good current technology. They had good people that understood a little bit about technology, can help us out, and a great partner in me, Mr. Partner. So they can say, would you say they were average? Well, they said they were above average by, you know, 2 or 3 times. So let's say they say 3. You put that number in, you hit the button, and then it's going to give you a quick analysis. It's going to basically say down here that they're only going to be down, from a restore standpoint, they're only going to be down 20 minutes a year. Okay, so that may sound good. However, based upon the cost of downtime and single loss, based upon Gartner, it still adds up to a significant amount of money per year at $31,000, which is an average loss per day of $85. If you implemented a HEROware solution, and what I did is I just took some generic partner numbers and threw those into roughly $200 a month, because we obviously have our subscription-based model that our partners love. You can buy it on a month, all in, hardware, software, service, support, everything else. you can actually spin up, as I said before, the Defender appliance spins up a new full replication of all servers in less than 5 minutes with the entire image that was on the server when it crashed. So you have an immediate replica of the entire server set. Your cost for that is, let's say, $400 a month. So your average cost per day of the Hero Defender is $13. This means your savings due to implementing Hero's Total Disaster Recovery Solutions is upwards of $75 a day. And that was for two servers, and they thought they were three times better than the average customer. So again, you haven't done anything as a partner. The only thing you've said is how many servers do you have? And I like to sort of reduce to the ridiculous, because you want to make it so easy that they agree with what you're doing. If they have four servers and they say, I'm so good, I'm five times better than anybody out there, their savings per day is still $70. So if they only had one server and they were five times better, the number is obviously going to drop, but there's still a $21 savings and the cost is only $200 a month, and they lost $10,000 that year. So again, this is a really, really good way to validate the whole concept of, do you believe in the cost of data and data protection? Slide one, yes. Do you agree that having a technology that hits all the data points in the eight tiers of IBM's 1955 analysis of disaster recovery? Yeah, I understand it. I think that's good. IBM's a pretty big company. They still have 23,000 people that are part of this group. They have so many, I think the number was 2,300 enterprises that still agree to this, the principles. Okay, great. So from that perspective, I agree to all this. When you get to this slide, this is the closing slide. You close on this slide. And this should really help you think how quickly you can actually sell them. Because if they put down a number here and you come up with $21 a day, and you're going to say, and you can multiply this by, you know, how many days in a year if you want to come up with their total savings per year. We can add this to the slide if you think that's important. You know, you can really, really sit down and say, okay, does this sound good? Can we move forward and, you know, buy a solution because of these savings? Every day we wait, you're potentially losing $10,000 for that year once a disaster happens, and $21 a day if you want to break it out over time. So anyway, that's how simple I've tried to reduce this presentation. We use it all the time as an organization in helping VARs sell, and customers love it. Again, a lot of these principles we've taken out of best practices from companies like Cisco and Dell, even HP we've spoken to, and you know, this is the type of stuff that high-end sales organizations use. It's all about TCO and ROI, and you have to get into that. Here, as you see, I really haven't talked about speeds and feeds. I haven't gone into how fast is it, how many snapshots do I back up, and all that. I didn't get into any of that, because you have to make the assumption that you've done your research as a partner and you vetted the technology, you agree the technology is going to do what it does for the customer based upon those eight guiding principles, and then you want to go a little bit deeper to make sure that there's a quality RMM tool in place like HEROware has, there's a great backup solution that HEROware has, I mean, things that we have and that other organizations either have or striving to get. So with that, I'm going to let you see this resource page, and we're exactly at the 30 minutes. If you haven't already, please go to http://heroportal.heroware.com and register to get an account. And in that account, you will get a secure cloud partner account that you can actually start onboarding customers. And I'll give you, we'll give you just some space that you can play with, from a test perspective. You also have access to getting started videos, sales and educational videos. This webinar will actually be on there as well, and the slides to go with it. There's also a link to buy now, where you have online purchasing from HEROware with your pricing. If you don't currently already have a special partner pricing from HEROware, make sure you register to get a e-commerce account, and we'll generate a special partner pricing for you, and you'll then get really, really good pricing. And then in here also are software downloads to download all the software you would need to set up your Hero Defender. And then we also have the secure client, and other licenses are in here. We will be posting shortly the cost of downtime slide, the eight tiers of disaster recovery slide, the Excel spreadsheet of the value selling plus, and I'm creating an online link as well. So then you can pull that up if you're traveling and you want to bring it up on a website. I'll make sure it's not in Flash, and therefore you can fire it up in an iPad and then just walk them through the value selling link on our website. You put a couple numbers in, you push a button, and you can hopefully do the TCO right in front of the customer and close it. Please let me know how this works. I think it works great. We've had some success from really good recent success with it, and we're very excited about. And then the recording of this webinar is obviously going to be posted as well. So let me get to some questions and answers. I see that we have quite a few queued up here. First question, how long should it take from initial presentation to close? What have you seen in HEROware? Great question. From the initial presentation, slide one through slide three, after you get with the customer, and you can obviously do this online. You don't have to be in front of the customer if you want to scale your business like we do it here at HEROware. You know, we're seeing anywhere from 2 to 3 weeks these days from start to finish, from beginning sales cycle to ending sales cycle. It really shouldn't take a heck of a lot longer than that with the technology and the products that we have out there. So, you know, we're pretty excited about how quick it is to close deals, and this should really help you do that. What type of markup should we expect when we sell your solution? You know, we're seeing anywhere from 30% upwards of 300% and everything in between. And then additives on installation and training. So I think the net result is you should probably get somewhere in the neighborhood of a double, 100% markup as you move forward. You know, I don't think that's unreasonable to get that. So that's a great question, and we get that question a lot. Next one is, you have prices on your website. Are you selling direct? No, we're absolutely not selling direct. The reason we post those prices on the website is really to give guidance to the customer that when they're buying from you, they know they're getting a really good deal. And then when you obviously add in training and installation, and those prices are about 300% markup from your prices in that range, that you in fact will look like the good guy. You know, we do not sell direct. We don't market direct. We only sell through our channel. Our channel has about 300 partners worldwide today and growing. We're sort of using the quality, not quantity methodology, where we really want you folks to be educated and trained on our product. So we think that's what part of this series is from an educational perspective. Next question, your solution looks great. Is it hard to learn? Well, that's a great question. On our website, we have 6 different videos that walk you through the environmental needs that we have, and they're very traditional and basic. You have to know some domain setups, walks you through how to do start the job, stop the job, create the job, and then how do you do the backup pieces for our secure suite component. So, you know, is it hard to do? No. If you put an hour in, maybe an hour and a half, and then you get your first box in, and then maybe we help you walk you through it after that, after you have put one in place and you understand it, it should be like clockwork. One of the things we're doing here at HEROware, we talk about every day, is making the product that much easier to not only consume, buy from HEROware, but also how to install and educate and then monitor and manage. So we're really understanding all the critical steps that you need as a proper, you know, partner to be able to go out and be successful selling these products. Question, can we have the presentation later? Yes, absolutely, you will have the presentation later. I will be working on putting that up on our website with my marketing team here and at the portal. Jim asked, how do we get a portal login? Go to this link. It's Hero, H-E-R-O, portal, P-O-R-T-A-L, all one word, .HEROware.com, and that's HTTP, and log in, and then there's a register button. Click the register button and go through the 6 or 8, you know, name, phone number, company name type things. And then a link will automatically be generated to us. We'll accept it. And then you'll have yourself, I'll create a secure cloud for you at the same time. And you'll be all set. You'll have everything that you need to get going. And then, you know, work with the sales team and, you know, talk about any opportunities you have. We'll help you do quotes. We'll help you obviously sell. We'll create an individual marketing material if you want. So, you know, we're very dedicated to the partner, and hopefully understood from my background is, you know, I work with IBM and back then Compaq and all the big players. And, you know, we were always about making sure that we had the proper literature and material based upon our customer set. We'll certainly do that for you. And we do a lot of branding. We're very, you know, into that. So anything you want us to brand for you, We can do, by the way, we can also brand your secured cloud client. So that client can be completely your brand, which is exciting. So any other questions? Don't see any other out there. Well, you know, you've been a great group. Thank you very much for your time today. Hopefully this was educational. I loved putting this presentation together. I got a lot out of it. And I really think that you'll do extremely well selling this way. So any questions, call us 1-866-810-4376, 866-810-4376, or just go to www.heroware.com and register for your HEROportal.heroware.com, and you know, hope to see you soon. By the way, for you, let you know, we'll be at the Excel User Conference next week in Las Vegas. We'll be at Interop the week after that in Las Vegas, and then we're going to the Autotask event, I think in June. So we're a busy group out here. So take care and have a great day.